Good morning, one and all. My name is T. Srikanth, Assistant Professor, Department of Tripoli, Nala Narasimha Reddy Group of Institutions, Hyderabad. I am dealing the subject poor quality for the final year, first semester, Tripoli students. Let's have a look into the introduction to the poor quality subject. The course objectives are, the first objective of the subject is definition of poor quality and different terms of poor quality. So we think that poor quality is nothing but a simple definition. Poor quality does not have a simple definition. So poor quality is not a simple term, it is a very broad classification. So we have so many definitions as well as so many meanings for the poor quality. So definition as well as the its related terms, definitions we will see as the first objective. The second objective of the subject are study of voltage poor quality issue, that is short and long interruptions. Okay, so majorly the poor quality deals with voltage issue. The voltage may be interrupted due to some disturbances. The disturbances may be either short interval or of long interval. Based on that, the interruptions are categorized into short as well as long interruptions. So study of voltage power quality issue, that is short interruptions as well as long interruptions, we will detailedly study. And the third objective is detailed study of characterization of voltage sag magnitude and three phase unbalanced voltage sag. So in this one, so what is meant by voltage sag? What are the characteristics of the voltage sag? So how to calculate the voltage sag for single phase as well as three phase unbalanced circuits? That we will discuss in the subject. The fourth objective is to know the behavior of power electronic loads, induction motors, synchronous motors, etc. by the power quality issue. So when the power quality deviates, so due to the problems of the power quality, so what is the behavior of the electronic loads like power electronic devices, etc. as well as induction motors, as well as synchronous motors, how the power quality changes, that is the behavior we will discuss. And in the fifth objective is overview of mitigation of power quality issues by voltage source inverter converters. How to reduce the power quality problems or issues with the help of the inverters, preferably voltage source inverters. So these are the five different course objectives of this subject. So coming to the course outcomes, so at the end of this course, the student can able to learn these outcomes. The first outcome is to know the severity of poor quality problems in distribution system. So every power quality problem has its severity. So the severity may change from one aspect to the other aspect. So the severity can we can able to completely determine. The second outcome is analyze the process of short and long interruptions. So how the short interruption can occur, what are the reasons for short interruption, so what are the qualities or characteristics of the short interruption, how to calculate the short interruption, etc. We'll discuss all these things. Similarly for long interruptions also. Coming to the third outcome, understand the concept of voltage sag transformation from upstream to downstream. So the third outcome is completely discuss about voltage sag. So how the voltage sag is developed, what are the reasons behind the voltage sag, how the voltage sag changes in single phase as well as the three phase circuits. So how the voltage sag will change from high voltage to low voltage side, that we will discuss clearly at the end of this course. Coming to the fourth outcome, estimate voltage sag in radial and mesh networks. So voltage sag changes from network to network. The voltage sag value will be different in radial network. The same voltage sag network voltage sag will be different in the mesh network. So what is the difference that we have to estimate? So estimation of the voltage sag in radial systems as well as a mesh network systems, similarly integrated systems, etc. We'll discuss clearly. Next, coming to the fifth outcome, discuss the concept of improving the power quality to sensitive load by various mitigating custom power devices. So the fifth outcome is, so after discussing about all the characteristics of the power quality problems as well as its effect on the power electronic equipment as well as the load equipment, etc. Finally, how to reduce the power quality problems, that is called as mitigation of power quality or improving of power quality with the help of different devices. They are called as custom power devices. Generally, power electronic devices are called as a custom power devices in which will mitigate the problems of the power quality and will improve the power quality. So at the end of this course, the student can able to learn all these 5 course outcomes. So coming to the syllabus, power quality. So the first unit deals with introduction to the power quality. What are the definitions? What are the terms definitions? So if you see the power quality terms, voltage sag, voltage fail, voltage surges, harmonics, over voltages, spikes, voltage fluctuations, transients, interruptions, etc. So we'll discuss about all these terms, what is the overview of the power quality, and what is the remedies to improve power quality and power quality model. This is the first unit. So in the second unit, we'll discuss about completely interruptions. Okay, so what are the two different classifications of the interruptions, like short interruption as well as long interruption. So in the first part, we'll discuss briefly on short interruption, what is the definition of interruption, what are the causes of the interruptions, as well as origin of interruptions, limits for the interruption frequency, cause of interruption, reliability, evaluation of power quality, comparison observations, and reliability evaluation. This is about long interruptions. Coming to the short interruptions, definition, origin of short interruptions, basic principle, same voltage magnitude events due to reclosing, voltage during the interruption, monitoring of short interruptions, difference between medium and low voltage systems, etc. All these things. So completely the second discuss about interruptions, both long as well as short, complete details. Coming to the third unit, we'll discuss about single and three phase voltage sag characterization. Okay. So first one is, what is voltage sag? Its definition, what are the causes of voltage sag? Voltage sag magnitude, monitoring, etc. All calculations we'll do. Similarly, we'll do the voltage sag characterization as well as calculations for three phase faults, phase angle jumps, magnitude and phase angle jumps for three phase unbalanced sags, etc. Okay. So coming to the fourth unit, in the fourth unit we'll discuss about power quality considerations in industrial power systems. Okay. So in industrial power systems, what are the requirements of the power quality? How the power quality should be maintained, that we'll discuss. So in industrial, what should be the voltage sag? What should be the behavior of the electronic loads like, power electronics, BJTs, thyristors, etc. Similarly, induction motors, synchronous motors, computers, consumer electronics, AC drives, DC drives, like this. So we'll discuss about this industrial systems, what are the power quality considerations. In the fifth unit, we'll discuss about the mitigation techniques for power quality improvement, mitigation of interruptions and voltage sags. So overview of mitigation methods, reduce the number of faults, reduce the fault clearing time, etc. These are all methods are related to mitigation of the interruption, mitigation of the voltage sag. Okay. For this, we require some different equipment. The equipment are system equipment interference, voltage source converter, series voltage controller, shunt controller, combined shunt and series controller. These are the different controllers to mitigate the interruption voltage sags. In the fifth unit, we have the finally power quality standards. So what should be the power quality standards? Power quality and EMC, electromagnetic compatibility standards. Introduction to standardization, IEC electromagnetic compatibility standards, European voltage characteristics standards, PQs. This is the syllabus. So in this entire 5 minutes, so we'll discuss chapter by chapter in the next classes. So the prescribed textbooks for the subject are Understanding Power Quality Problems, written by Matt H.J. Bolin, IEEE Press 2000. Similarly, another textbook is Power Quality Work Compensation in Power Systems by R. Shastri Vedam and Mulakutla S. Sharma, CRC Press 2003. These two textbooks are available in the library. You can take it and you can read it. So reference books. The reference books are Shri Shankaran Power Quality, CRC Press 2001. Similarly, Roser C. Dugan, Mark F. M. C. Granagan, Surya Santoso, H. Wayne B. T. Electrical Power System Quality, Tata McGraw-Hill Education Private Limited, 3rd edition 2012. This is the reference books. This is about the subject as well as syllabus. So coming to the first unit, introduction, that is, what is the definition of power quality? So if you look into what is the definition of power quality, Power quality, we have so many definitions from different aspects. Okay, so from aspect to aspect, the power quality definition will change. First, we'll see one by one. Okay, the first definition is according to utility. So according to utility, the power quality is nothing but simply called as reliability. Power quality simply called as reliability according to utility. So utility point of means the power supply should not deviate, so it should not disturb. Okay, so reliability, what is reliability? Throughout whatever may be the problems, so we should get continuity of power supply. That is done with the quality. If power quality is less, automatically we cannot get continuity of power supply. Reliable power is not available. Therefore, from utility point of view, power quality is simply called as reliability. Next, coming to the second aspect, according to load aspect. According to load aspect, it is defined as the power supplied for satisfactory performance of all equipment, that is all sensitive equipment. So from load point of view, if you define the power quality, it's simply defined as the power supplied for satisfactory performance of all equipment. Okay? Suppose, for example, if the supply, if an appliance is connected to the supply, okay, if the appliance operates, okay, with a satisfactory performance during the given time interval, then we can call it as the power is quality. Simply. Okay. For example, okay, if the lifetime of a equipment, okay, some equipment is 5 years. So if the equipment will work for 5 years without any disturbance in the performance, then quality of the power is good. For example, during these 5 years, at the end of 2 years or 3 years, if the equipment is damaged partially or completely, then we can call it as performance of the equipment is not good because of power quality problem. Okay, so unsatisfactory performance. So if there is satisfactory performance, then it is called as a quality problem. Next, coming to third definition, this depends upon the end user. So user point of view, how we can define power quality. Okay, so according to end user point of view, it is defined as any power problem manifested in voltage, current or frequency deviations that result in failure or misoperation of custom. Any power quality problem, either deviation in the voltage or deviation in the current or deviation in the frequency that result in failure of the customer equipment or misoperation of the customer equipment. If the customer equipment will not operate or will fail to operate, okay, then the problem is called as power quality problem. The problem may be either in the voltage, the problem may be either in the current or in the frequency. That is power. Coming to the fourth definition, this is a standard definition, very, very standard definition. In IEEE, IEEE dictionary, power quality is defined as the concept of powering and grounding sensitive equipment in a matter that is suitable to the operation of that equipment. So IEEE means very, very standard, international standard of dictionary. So in this one, the concept of powering and grounding sensitive equipment in a matter that is suitable to the operation of the equipment. So how all sensitive equipment will work with satisfactory performance without any deviation, that is called as power quality. Okay. Next, the fifth definition is IEC, International Electrotechnical Commission. This is also a standard commission, one of the standard definition. It is defined as set of parameters defining the properties of the power supply as delivered to the user in normal operating conditions in terms of continuity of supply and the characteristics of voltage. Okay, so in IEC standard point of view, set of parameters defining the properties of the power supply as delivered to the user in normal operating conditions in terms of continuity of power supply and characteristics of the voltage. Okay, that means the power quality of power is nothing but it is measured in terms of continuity of the supply and what is the magnitude of the voltage, magnitude of the frequency, magnitude of the voltage waveform, and its characteristics. If all are satisfactory, then the power is nothing but quality power. If anyone deviates from the respected values, automatically representative value, automatically the quality of power is low vacancy. Therefore, IEC standard is one of the good definition we can easily remember. So coming to the how the power quality is evaluated. Okay, the power quality, the power supply system can only control the quality of the voltage. It has no control over the current. Particular loads might drop. So always power quality is always related to only voltage. Voltage can be deviated, voltage can be controlled, but current cannot be controlled because current is depends on always load. When the load changes, automatically current can change. So I cannot control the current, but I can control the voltage. Okay, I can fix the limits for the voltage. That is done with the help of improving the power quality. Therefore, the standards in the power quality are related to maintain the supply voltage within certain limits. Voltage should be always kept within the certain limits. Therefore, we can say it is a quality of power. The power quality evaluation procedure. Power quality evaluation procedure. The following gives the general steps that are often required in a power quality investigation, along with the major considerations that must be addressed at each step. Okay. So, the power quality evaluation procedure, it has five steps. In the first step, we have to identify what is the problem category, whether it is comes under voltage regulation or unbalance, voltage sags or interruptions, flicker, transients or harmonic distortion. Okay. This we need to identify. So any one of this category, the problem it belongs to. After this, second step is problem characterization. What are the characteristics of the problem? So we should get the data from measurements or data collection. But a measure, then we have to, then only we can get the characteristics. So in this one, the first one is causes. From by the measurements, we'll get what are the causes for the problem, what are the characteristics of the problem. Third one is what are the equipment impacts of the problem. That we'll listen. Okay, that we'll see. Next, in the step three, identify a range of solutions. Utility transmission system, utility distribution system, end-use customer interface, end-use customer system, equipment design or specifications. So among which is deviating, so which comes under which category? So what is the solutions? We have to change the transmission system or distribution system or end-user customer interface system or customer system or equipment specifications or design. We need to change. We have to see. Okay. So what changes will make the power quality good? That we need to see. After the identify the range of solutions, then we need to evaluate. The fourth step is evaluate solutions. So we need to model or analyze the procedures to get the evaluation results. So evaluate technical alternatives. Once we'll get, then we'll get the fifth step, that is optimum solution. So for optimum solution, evaluate economics of possible solutions. Okay. So we'll stop here. This is the first class introduction. So we'll discuss about these classes of power quality problems in the next class. Thank you, one and all.